So I used to go on walks around my neighborhood, and this was around springtime. I would look at all the beautiful flowers and just be in awe by their radiance. And I did this a lot when I began very seriously meditating a few years ago. So I would go and I would feel like I was so awakened to this magnificent beauty all around me that I had never seen before. And so I was flabbergasted. And what I started doing was I would look at these flowers and how beautiful they were, and I would pick them. And I would take them home with me, these different arrangements, and I would put them in a little vase and put them in my kitchen. And just loved doing that. And as soon as they would die, I would throw them out and pick new ones. I started to become very aware of what I was doing there. And this is so common for human beings to want to possess that which they find beautiful, that which they find desirable. They can't just enjoy it from a distance. They need to have it. And the more I started to become aware of that, the more I started to realize, well, first of all, you're kind of killing the flowers when you take them from their home. They're there to brighten everybody's day. Who says that you can take them? I'm not saying that this is the wrong thing to do. This is what the conclusion that I came to. And I just really started to question myself. And as I was getting very serious into meditating at that point, I couldn't get away with just continuing to do that which I had been doing. So, what is it in me? I asked myself, what is it in me that is wanting for these flowers to be mine? Why can't I just enjoy them from a distance? And as soon as I started to ask myself those questions, that desire faded away and I no longer really wanted to take the flowers. So I started taking my camera with me every single time I went on a walk and photographing the flowers. And I would create beautiful images very up close to the flower. What I loved doing was to go and get under the tree and take the camera up and just photograph the tree from the, I guess, the perspective of an ant. Notice if you do this as well. Most people do. It's not just with the flowers. It's with a partner, someone that you are attracted to. And